Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about a relationship between biomass and substrate concentration. We already have relationships between specific growth rate, substrate concentration, dilution rate, flow rate, volume and all that, but in this video we are going to talk about a relationship between biomass and substrate concentration. I hope you remember this diagram for CSTR, and that is continuous stirred tank reactor. And in this, if you see, the inflow rate is F and the outflow rate is also F, so that we maintain a constant volume. Now there are certain parameters which remain constant under steady state in a chemostat or continuous stirred tank reactor, and those are volume, then S, that is the substrate concentration, steady state substrate concentration. Now this steady state substrate concentration is present inside this homogeneous mixture, okay. Then there is steady state biomass concentration, again it is present inside this homogeneous mixture. Now for finding the relationship between substrate concentration and biomass, what we do a mass balance, substrate mass balance, okay. We call it mass balance for substrate. So what we do in that, so we write an equation which states that the substrate which is flowing in, the rate at which substrate is flowing in, the rate at which substrate is flowing out, the rate of generation of substrate inside the bioreactor and the rate of consumption of substrate inside the bioreactor. So if we subtract out minus in and add it to consumption minus generation, it is equals to accumulation, okay. So the substrate which is flowing in minus the substrate which is flowing out, then substrate which is getting generated minus the substrate which is getting consumed is equals to the accumulation of substrate inside the bioreactor. Now if we see what is the substrate flowing in, the rate at which substrate is flowing in is equals to F, which is the flow rate, into the substrate concentration inside the flow rate, okay. This depicts the rate at which the substrate is flowing in minus the rate at which substrate is flowing out, again F is the outflow rate, and whatever is there in this homogeneous mixture is going to flow out through the outflow, and this contains steady state substrate concentration. So F outflow rate, again the substrate concentration in the outflow, which is the steady state substrate concentration, plus the rate of generation. Now there is no substrate generated inside the bioreactor, okay, so it is zero, minus the rate of consumption. Now for finding out the rate of consumption, we should know the substrate consumed per unit biomass, and then we will multiply it with the entire biomass, okay. So which means that suppose S is the complete substrate, X is the entire biomass generated. Now we get substrate consumed per unit biomass, and now if we multiply it with the rate at which biomass is being generated inside the bioreactor, which is mu XV, okay, this is small x. Now mu is the rate, specific growth rate, X is the biomass concentration in unit volume, and to get the growth rate in the entire volume, we multiply it by capital V, which is the entire volume of the bioreactor, okay. So by this formula we are going to get the substrate which is being consumed, or the rate at which the substrate is being consumed inside the entire volume. So let's revise this. This is the substrate, entire substrate which is consumed inside during the process, entire biomass which is produced. This term gives us the substrate consumed per unit biomass, okay. Now we multiply it with the rate at which biomass is being generated, and the rate is represented by specific growth rate, biomass concentration per unit volume multiplied by the entire volume, okay. So we write it here, substrate consumed per unit biomass multiplied by the specific growth rate multiplied by the steady state substrate concentration and the entire volume is equals to, now the accumulation, accumulation inside a bioreactor is zero because we say that the volume is constant, so there is nothing which is getting accumulated inside the bioreactor, so it also becomes zero. Now if we see, one term is there which represents the yield, okay. So what is yield? So yield represents the biomass produced per unit consumption of substrate. So it is the biomass produced per unit consumption of substrate. So how much substrate was consumed for a particular amount of biomass, or we can say how much biomass was consumed for a unit substrate, okay. So this represents yield, and it is represented by Y X by S, okay. So this term yield is represented by Y X by S. So do you think, can we write this term S by X as 1 by yield, we can write this term S by X is equals to 1 by yield. Okay, so we are going to replace this S by X with this term, so we get it as F S in minus S steady state. I have taken F as common. Now minus 1 by Y X by S mu X V is equals to 0. Okay, I transpose this term there, so I am going to get F sin S is equals to 1 by Y X by S mu X. Now if I transpose this V here, I am going to get F by V, and we know F by V is D, that is the dilution rate. So dilution rate and mu is equal at steady state concentration. Okay, so this F by V represents the dilution rate, and dilution rate and mu are equal under steady state condition, so we can cancel these out and we get a formula which is X under steady state condition is equals to Y X by S multiplied by S in minus S steady state. So this is the formula which we get, this is the relation which we get between steady state biomass concentration and the substrate. So this is steady state biomass concentration, this is the yield which is biomass produced per unit substrate, this represents the substrate which is flowing in, okay, the concentration of substrate flowing in or the concentration of substrate inside the feed, this represents the substrate concentration under steady state conditions. Now there are many questions, many numericals which are based on this formula, and if you see this steady state substrate concentration, we can replace it by the steady state substrate concentration can be replaced by KSD upon mu max minus D. So this is S in Y X by S is equals to X. So now we get a relationship between biomass, steady state concentration of biomass, dilution rate, mu maximum, S, M and yield. Okay, so these both formulas are very important from the point of view of gate biotechnology exam. In the description of this video, you will find a few questions based on this particular formula which appeared in previous year's gate biotechnology exam. So please do go through those questions, and the answers are mentioned in the description only. Thank you.